Hello viewers and learners, I extend a warm welcome to the present module on digital assessment tools. With today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. In the era of digital learning environment, digital assessment tools have been designed and adorned as a unique feature of blended learning and flipped classrooms. These digital tools are highly utilized by teachers as a valuable tool for critical understanding and higher learning attainment. Among different types of digital tools, as discussed in previous modules, digital assessment tools are becoming popular for their unique characteristics in 21st century. When teachers know their students well, they can build strong connections that lead to a better learning. Knowing students' interests, strengths, and weaknesses help teachers tailor learning experiences for their students. Formative assessment involves the teacher collecting information about what students know, don't know, and want to learn. In some classrooms, edutainment, which is a mix up of the two words, education and entertainment, using digital resources is seen as a way to keep kids and students engage in learning. But some of the teachers argue that in the real world learning, it is not all fun and games. And they worry that students' reliance or dependence on technology may diminish their ability to concentrate and think through complex issues. The present module highlights the conceptual and practical understanding of digital assessment tools as a distinct type of digital tools, and it demonstrates as how these tools are affecting teaching and learning experiences. So first of all, let's enumerate the learning outcomes of this module. Learners will be able to understand, number one, understanding digital assessment concept. Number two, meaning of educational assessment and its essence. Number three, types of educational assessments. Number four, need of digital assessment in 21st century. Number five, features of digital assessment. Number six, tips for combining power of assessment for learning and digital tools. And number seven, types of using digital assessment tools. Number eight, popular tools for digital assessment. Now let's proceed towards understanding of digital assessment. Digital assessment refers to a software that serves as an interactive assessment tool in educational setting. It may be defined as an evaluation and judgment of learners' progress through digital tools and technology. It also refers to use of electronic systems and software to assess and evaluate the progress of individual learners in educational settings. This is not a learning management system. It does not attempt to teach or instruct. It is only a mechanism of feedback to measure the learner's progress through technology for a particular learning context. In fact, digital assessment is concerned with working smartly by moving from paper-based assignments to digital form with an instant feedback. Now, let's learn about the meaning of an educational assessment. Teachers must have a clear understanding of the principles of good assessment and feedback practice for integrating a wide range of technologies into their pedagogical designs at all stages of their learning programs. In education, the term assessment refers to a wide variety of methods or tools that educators use to evaluate, measure, and document the academic readiness, learning progress, skill acquisition, or educational needs of students. It is the process of measuring the knowledge, skill, and attitude of a learner before and after a learning experience. Assessment is embedded in the learning process, and it is a tightly connected with curriculum. Now, let's explore as why assessments are necessary. Number one, assessments are necessary for effective instruction. It helps to know what the learner's performance in teaching and learning experiences. Number two, it assists the learner's smooth understanding and self-assessment in learning. Number three, it delivers high-quality feedback information that helps learners self-correct. Number four, assessments play a pivotal role to encourage teacher-learner and peer dialogue. Number five, it also encourages positive motivational beliefs and self-esteem among teachers and learners. It provides opportunities to act on feedback from learners to improve teaching. Now let's step forward towards discussing on types of educational assessment. Primarily, there are three types of educational assessments, and these are: number one, formative assessment; number two, summative assessment; and number three, diagnostic assessment. Now let's understand the difference among these kind of assessments. Formative assessment is concerned with measuring learner progress of feedback during the class or while class is going on. It helps the teacher to assess about the knowledge of content material, as how much learner has grasped the content. The second is summative assessment. Summative assessment takes place after the learning has been completed, and it provides information and feedback that sums up the teaching and learning process. Third is diagnostic assessment. Diagnostic assessment can help to recognize students' current knowledge of a subject, their skill set and capabilities, and to clarify misconceptions before teaching takes place. Knowing students' strengths and weaknesses can help to make better plan what to teach and how to teach it. Now let's step forwards towards discussing the need of digital assessment in 21st century. In 21st century, when every young learner is digital native and old pedagogy has been transformed into a new pedagogy, it requires digital assessments in place of traditional assessments. Digital assessment tools help teachers to plan, design, and generate better learning experiences. Further, it is quite important for teachers and learners to know the real concept and spirit of digital assessment while using any learning management system or tool or software available in different flavors, such as course management system, learning management system, and learning content management system, which we have already discussed in the previous modules. Learning management system and learning content management system, we already have differentiated. So only after in-depth understanding of these tools, the digital assessment may be carried out as expected as well as successfully. There are numerous reasons for utilizing digital assessments, such as number one, learners are digital native. This is the first reason. It becomes easy, convenient, attractive, and motivating for them to provide feedback or assessments in the digital forms. It is just like fun for them. So it expands learners' commitment. Second reason, while using digital assessments, it is quite time saving. It offers fast feedback and it also reduces the workload of teachers. Documentation becomes easy and permanent. There is no fear of losing paper and assessments related documents. Third reason, digital assessments are better than traditional paper assessments because it ensures validity, reliability, and transparency with fast and fair, and that too directly after conducting a test. Now let's explore the features of digital assessments. The special features of digital assessment include several, such as number one, provision of speedy marking process and feedback. What it does? It increases efficiency and it also reduces workload. Number two, increased learner autonomy and self-evaluation. Number three, wider variety of techniques to engage and support, opportunities to design richer and that too more interactive. Number four, publish, share, track, and celebrate progress. So cloud-based assessments are providing automatic archiving of assessments, grades, and feedback for quiz questions or other kind of assessments. Number five, generating reports. Number six, automatic allocation for peer assessments in the form of online tests or quizzes. Number seven, provide supports and foster independence. Number eight, connect online to offline instruction. Number nine, taken in real time by all students or in homework mode. Number 10, multiple choice questions, MCQs, which shows your work. It also gets you short answer or true false questions. Number 11, questions can include images or videos too. Number 12, it may upload existing assessments and add your own contents too. Now further, now let's explore as what can be the advice or tips for combining power of assessment for learning and the digital tools. The first step is determine the purpose for using the online environment to accelerate learning. This will establish the online environment that you will set up. Do you want a student-centered e-portfolio or blog That is the student's story of their own learning? Or do you want a digital platform to share data and student achievement, or a combination of both? Ensure your institution has consulted widely to gather perspectives from students, parents, teachers, and leadership. Next, focus the discussion on the pedagogy rather than the system. Second tip is, carefully consider the digital platform you choose to adopt for your education institution. It may be for a school, college, university, or a training center. Having determined the agreed purpose for your digital context, also consider security, aesthetics, user friendliness, capacity to facilitate social networking, user storage space, capacity to access, edit, contribute from mobile devices, capacity to demonstrate learning, comment, reflect, and feed forward on learning. Ease of embedding popular tools such as Web 2.0 or 3.0 or 4.0 tools or more into the selected system. Also, identify ownership of the chosen digital portfolio. When students transfer from one institution to another and beyond. Third tip is, use the ARC way of assessment for learning capabilities from Absalom's clarity in the classroom to develop the spirit of assessment capability as the embedded classroom culture. Fourth tip is, amplify each assessment capability using fit for purpose digital apps. Examples include Flipgrid, Explain Everything, Evernote, VoiceThread, Google Apps for Education, which are quite good to track the learning journey, capture student voice and artifacts as evidence of your students' learning capabilities as they possess. Fifth tip, hand learning ownership over to your students by sharing the big picture, relevance, accountability, and transparency for the learning with your students. Embed the process of reflection using the online environment into your daily classroom program. Set aside time to deliberately teach protocols on how to reflect and give feedback in the online environment. Engage the expertise of talented students to support implementation of digital tools to support assessment for learning. Sixth tip is, engage in professional development to support using digital tools to ensure all capabilities are embedded and sustained. For successful integration of digital tools to amplify assessment for learning, teachers will need to see and believe in the power of the pedagogy, supported by the digital tools as central to the learning process rather than as an add-on. Next to all these tips, now let's explore what are the different ways of using digital assessment tools. There are primarily three ways of using digital assessment tools. First one, gamification. The gamification of learning is an educational approach to motivate students to learn by using video game design and game elements in learning environments. The goal of gamification is to maximize enjoyment and engagement through capturing the interest of learners and inspiring them to continue learning. There are numerous ways to bring games and game playing into the classroom content area to promote learning and understanding among students. The teacher can upload media files and images to create a unique game or to download ready-made stuff to make the learning useful and interesting. Second method is giving instant feedback. Some digital tools and software are equipped with various features that can be used by educators for many different purposes. It also includes several activities like quizzes, quick questions, and exit tickets for giving instant feedback. These tools allow educators to get immediate insights into their student understanding in real time, as they can create quizzes in seconds and also share these with other teachers too. Third method is tracking progress. We may use digital tools that assist us to understand exactly where their students stand in terms of progress. There are several interesting tools for this kind of digital assessment, as many students consider it to be a fun game, which makes the study and learning process even much easier. There are also some more methods too, apart from these three. Number four, creating survey-based assessment. Teachers usually develop MCQs, that is multiple choice questions, short questions, large questions to assess the learner's performance. Through digital tools, we can make or create these kind of digital assessments too. After discussing these methods, now let's step forwards towards discussing the ways of using digital assessment tools. There are several digital assessment tools which are very popular among learners and teachers. Few of these tools include like Google Forms, Kahoot, Quizlet Live, Socrative, Nearpod, and ChipGrid. So after having the conceptual understanding of the digital assessment tools and having noted our several digital assessment tools as I just named, now let's sum up the entire module in the nutshell. In this module, what we could discuss in detail, that was about digital assessment tools by focusing on understanding digital assessment, meaning of educational assessment and its need, types and kinds of educational assessments, need of digital assessment in the 21st century, features of digital assessment, tips for combining power of assessment for learning and digital tools, ways and types of using digital assessment tools, and enumerating popular tools for digital assessment. I hope that you would have enjoyed the present module on digital assessment tools. We will join you soon with another module by focusing on practical orientation exposure of few popular digital assessment tools. Thanks a lot, learners, for enjoying this module as well as for your active participation in this module. Thank you very much.